Interior Secretary Benhur Abalos denies giving Alice Go special treatment. That's after photos of a smiling Go with him and other government officials circulated online, sparking outrage from Philippine senators. Senator Joel Villanueva criticized the officials in the photos, calling their behavior unprofessional. His colleague Rizo Ontiveros, for her part, reminded officials that Go is a criminal, not a celebrity. Go, meanwhile, explained she was smiling because she felt safe with Abalos and PNP Chief Romel Marbil after receiving death threats.
Meron po akong death threats po at humingi po ako ng tulong po sa kanila at masaya din po ako na nakita ko po sila. I feel safe po.
Nag-request si Alice na kausapin kaming dalawa ni Chief. At sinabi niya nga na meron siya mga death threats. At inassure ko siya, kami ni Chief, na yung death threats, huwag niya alalahanin, importante, sabihin niya lahat ng totoo.
Dismissed Philippine Town Mayor Alice Go now back in the Philippines after fleeing the country undetected in July. Go was escorted back to Manila by Philippine Police Chief Romel Marbil and Interior Secretary Benhur Abalos, who carried the arrest warrant issued by the Senate. Upon her arrival at 1 a.m. Friday, the Bureau of Immigration arrested Go and took her into legal custody, while police assumed physical custody. At around 3 in the morning, Go was transferred to the National Police Headquarters in Quezon City. She is expected to appear before the Senate later today.
Bandang tanghalian, nakatanggap ako ng tawag na binibigyan tayo ng alauna ng madaling araw dahil nalakip ng mga Indonesian authorities si Alice Go, na kung hindi ito aayusin ng Pilipinas, makapakawala nila si Alice Go. So dahil sa panahon na yun, agad tayo naganap ng eroplano. May kaibigan ako nagpahiram ng eroplano para lang magawa ito sa mas madaling paraan. Ising ko, wala akong ginastos ang pamahalaan dito.
Go was apprehended late Tuesday in Tangerang City, Indonesia. Also known as Chinese national Go Hua Ping, she is wanted by the Senate for refusing to attend a congressional probe into her alleged ties to Chinese criminal syndicates and money laundering. Alice Go and her companions may face imprisonment over 1,000 years. That is according to the Anti-Money Laundering Council, citing 87 counts of money laundering they are facing. This warning was issued by senators on Thursday to urge Sheila Go, the alleged sister of the dismissed mayor, to tell the truth. But Sheila still stuck to her story, asserting she doesn't know the answers to some of the lawmakers' questions.
Dumaan kami sa maning tawag ng toll gate papunta Skyway. Diretso na yun, hindi ko alam kung saan na yun.
May tatak yung passport mo, entered Saba.
Alam ko.
So may tatak.
Opo.
Ang problema, hindi nagmamatch ang stamp sa totoong dapat na stamp kung Saba talaga ang baba ninyo. According to these stamps, July 18 or basa ng iba, July 19 kayo pumasok sa Malaysia. Pero via Kuala Lumpur. Sa makatuwid, nauna ka dapat sa Kuala Lumpur kaysa sa Saba.
Another name also being dragged to the Gomez, Sawal Pangasinan Mayor Liseldo Dong Kalugay, now being suspected as the lover of the former mayor. Senator Sherwin Gatchalian said he received information that the Go family's business, Alicel Aqua Farm in Sawal, is the combination of the names Alice and Liseldo. Kalugay was invited to the hearing, but he said he has dengue.
Ano ang relasyon niya kay Alice?
Sabi niya, kaibigan po.
Kaibigan? Wala ba silang boyfriend-girlfriend relationship?
Sabi hindi.
Sabi Nino?
Ni Alice.
A regional appellate court nullifies a temporary protection order previously granted to the religious sect of fugitive Philippine televangelist Apollo Quiboloy. It says that Davao City Regional Trial Court had acted without authority in granting the protection order to the Kingdom of Jesus Christ, or KOJC. The Cagayan de Oro Appellate Court says it found no basis for the issuance of the order. The Davao Court had directed police to cease their search and arrest efforts in the KOJC compound. Davao City authorities say they are ready to face an inquiry from the Senate Panel on Justice and Human Rights probing their operations. The Davao Regional Police Chief says efforts to search the entire KOJC compound have allegedly been restricted by Quiboloy's followers. The KOJC on Thursday released videos of the supposed police excavation activities in their Davao City compound.
Kasi ang bottom line lang dito, kung hindi natin mahuli si Quiboloy sa ganitong paraan pa na ating ginawa, ang ending hindi pa rin natin nahuli. Ano pa ang pwede natin gawin para mahuli siya? Sundin ng presidente ang demand niya na magbigay ng pumirma na isang deklarasyon na siya ay ganito-ganito.
A special assistant to ex-Philippine presidential spokesman Harry Roque is questioned about their financial ties by a joint congressional panel probing their links to illegal offshore gaming operations. Details from Jeffrey Arnaez.
The House Quad Committee rejected former presidential spokesperson Harry Roque's motion to quash a subpoena that required him to submit documents to the joint panel, including his business records, tax returns, and statement of assets, liabilities, and net worth, or SALEN. The lawmakers want to find out if Roque profited from Pogo Hubs. The Quadcom also requested Roque to explain why he did not attend the hearings held on August 28 and September 4. But Roque's executive assistant, A.R. De La Serna, attended Wednesday's hearing. Congressman questioned him about his joint bank account with Roque. De La Serna did not answer how much was in the joint account, but confirmed that he was able to withdraw millions from it.
I have a joint account with Attorney Roque. Sa pagkakalam ko, Mr. Chair, close na po yung account na yun. Around 1.2 to 1.8, Mr. Chair.
Yung na-withdraw mo?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
So marami kang withdrawal na malalaki?
Parang once a month yun, Mr. Chair, before for election purposes naman yun, Mr. Chair, for payroll po ng mga tao po.
De La Serna also revealed that he traveled abroad with Roque 6 times in 2023.
First trip was a trip to Hong Kong po. For sa pagkalala ko, Mr. Chair, yun po yung premiere night ng isang movie po with the Marcos family po. Movie po with ni Senator Amy po, Mr. Chair. May premiere night po sa Hong Kong that time.
ABS-CBN tried to get the side of Roque, but he has yet to provide a statement. The hearing conducted Wednesday by the House of Representatives Quad Committee on the issue of Pogo was delayed for several minutes after Cassandra Leong, the authorized representative of Lucky South 99, suffered a medical emergency caused by low blood pressure. She was later admitted to the hospital for treatment. According to House Secretary General Reginald Velasco, Ong is now in stable condition. Before Ong was rushed to the hospital, she was questioned about the torture videos obtained by authorities, allegedly from a Pogo hub in Porac.
Pwede niyo pupuntahan ang Porac, Pampanga. Wala po kayong makikitang any background na ganun yung room ng torture.
Ong was also questioned about the source of funds of her business partners.
Hindi kaya galing sa drugs ang negosyo ng mga partner mo, yung mga kasosyo mo?
Sigurado po ako, hindi po.
But Ong confirmed that Whirlwind top executive Duan Renwu was a former Chinese police officer.
Simpleng police lang po siya.
Yun. So, actually,
pero again, nag-resign na rin po siya.
In fact, marami siyang record. Alam mo ba na may mga record siya sa pagiging police? Maraming negative na record siya doon sa China.
The House will coordinate with the Senate to invite former Bambantarlac Mayor Alice Go to the next hearing. Jeffrey Hernaez, ABS-CBN News.
The chair of the Philippine Energy Regulatory Commission is handed a six-month preventive suspension. The ombudsman suspended Mona Lisa de Malanta for allegedly violating a law regulating the sale of electricity. The ombudsman had acted on a complaint of the National Association of Electricity Consumers for Reforms. The group alleged that De Malanta had illegally allowed the Meralco power distributor to bill consumers for more expensive energy bought from the wholesale electricity spot market. De Malanta has declined to comment on her suspension. Former radio broadcaster Cesar Chavez is the new press secretary of Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Chavez was sworn in to replace Cheloy Garafil, who was appointed to lead Manila's de facto embassy in Taiwan. Chavez was previously the head of the Light Rail Transit Authority under the Duterte administration. Chavez denies his appointment was an abrupt change in the presidential communications office.
Maliwanag ko ang aking task dito, to communicate for the presidency, to communicate for the government, and to communicate for the state. This is not an undertaking of the PCO, is this an undertaking of the entire government bureaucracy, especially the communications team.
A regional trial court dismisses terror charges filed by the Philippine military against 34 activists. The court in Malolos dismissed the charges against Makabayan Secretary General Nathaniel Santiago and 33 others for lack of probable cause. The terror complaints were filed in May by soldiers who claimed the activists were involved in an armed clash last year that killed a government trooper.